Library Month is an annual celebration that's done nationally, and Vancouver Island Regional Library has taken an active role in celebrating our communities. Last year we celebrated our seniors community. The year before that we did a fines amnesty, so we're always doing something to get our community in. This year we decided to highlight the LGBTQ2+ community.
The Safe Space stickers were part of an earlier campaign in the year celebrating Pride Month. The point of those stickers is to really get the message across. This space is a safe space, and so the stickers were created and they're up on the entryway of our branches. It's an indicator on the front of our door for people from the LGBTQ2+ community that those spaces are safe for them and welcoming for them, and that we want them there.
Well, it's important for people to know that they're welcome. So it's nice. If you see one of those stickers, then you know that you're welcome and it's a safe space for you, and that nobody is going to judge you, which is great. So
I've seen some of those stickers around on some of the local businesses, and I think it's fantastic. I didn't realize that it was the library that had spearheaded that.
The response in the community has been just fantastic. You know, our staff, our customers, the community have embraced this. We've had some great opportunities to program and highlight our facilities, how warm and welcoming they are, and to highlight our staff and what they can do to provide information. And we've also had some great performers come in. Drag Queen Storytime has been one of the most popular programs during the month of October. I don't know who was having the most fun, the kids or the parents.
So Drag Queen Story Times are something that have taken off all over North America and hopefully all over the world. This type of story time is really important for kids because it gives them an opportunity to see someone who might be like them or who might be completely different from them.
The purpose of Drag Queen Story Hour for us is that it's a way that we can engage the LGBTQ community in Nanaimo while still accomplishing the early childhood literacy goals that we have in the library. Drag Queen Story Hour creates a welcoming, vibrant atmosphere that's fun and engaging, where folks can really feel like they're being themselves. And it's also an opportunity for us to take a leadership role in the community and show that we're doing something that we're proud of.
I feel like a lot of people are scared of things they don't know and things that they don't understand. So if some kids haven't seen this before or they're not used to that, of course they're going to have, you know, suspicious reaction to it. I kind of see like their minds exploding, going like, I can do that, I can be that, I can look like that. Is it okay for me to dress like that? The fact that they are being allowed to be who they are.
Did you like the drag queen? She was beautiful. We were just talking about her makeup and how sparkly it was and how pretty it was.
You know, having different readers, different lifestyles, different walks of life coming in and sharing stories is really important.
The chosen name procedure is something that we changed internally about the way that we welcome customers when they were signing them up for library cards.
When you're trans, you generally change your name, so you have your birth name, and if my birth name is Arabella, but I really am a boy, that's not going to work very well. And when you come into the library to get a card, you need to have your ID to show who you are so that we can lend you stuff. So we wanted to make sure that if, you know, I come in and my name's Eric, that there's an option for me even if it's not on my ID.
This campaign has been just a wonderful demonstration of how all of our staff pull together to make a very inclusive strategy. At the end of the month, when the campaign ends, nothing changes. Our mission, vision, and values enable us to make everyone welcome, everyone feel comfortable, and that's what we do. So we're just going to continue to do what we do and what we do well, and ensure that all members of our community feel warm and welcome in our VIRL locations.